Yeah.
I like a warrior.
Gorillas in the mouth. Scenery so far, there's snowbanks, there's snow. We saw some mountains coming in that we're gonna go on, and I just can't wait. Like, I'm so stoked.
We're gonna start to a military base here, and then we're going to the Sierra Nevada volcano. Beautiful views from up there, lakes, huge volcanoes. It's gonna be really, really nice.
What's up, everybody? Here in South America, in Chile, and first time riding here ever. I'm checking out the snowpack today with Carl and examining the layers, and it's definitely a spring snowpack. It's pretty wet for most of it until you get about 140 centimeters down. There's a pretty hard layer.
I think that's a moose.
It could be a moose. You definitely don't want to go in there on
the jawbone is right there.
Stuck of your lifetime if you're that guy.
Yeah, he's stuck for life.
This beautiful thing behind me is an araucario. Araucario. I'm working on my Spanish and rolling my R still. But apparently it's like 5,000 years old, the species is, and it's native to this district in Chile. I've been told that you really don't want to hit the branches because they're really sharp and robust and they rip gear and hurt. So if you're ever here, stay away from them.
First day of riding, we were out pretty late, like 8 o'clock at night, pitch black, out in the middle of the middle. I mean, literally out in the middle of nowhere.
With my road, you remember you go by the trees when we get stuck at the beginning?
We went by a lot of trees.
Yeah, okay. I make a turn when I get stuck, and I make that trail, and we're gonna take that direction because it's so easy to go. It's a long way. We have at least 1 more hour to go.
You know, I think your middle name should be Never Home Before Dark. Because every trip I've ever had with you is dark.
50-50 warranty. 50 feet or 50 seconds, whatever happens first.
So then, whatever, we got that out. Now it's pitch black. Jay's got sandstorm. We took a couple shortcuts down another valley, ran out of snow, had to double back.
We had this thing called the Bridge of Death, which was pretty horrifying for everybody. It's a 15, 20 foot drop into a river with logs. It's pitch black. Let's get the heck out of here as soon as possible.
When we were hooking the trailer up, we
busted the headlight out of his sled.
Yeah, Jaime, we made a little scratch in your stuff.
Because it's pitch black.
Well, yeah. And we're on a tiny little road, like trying to...
So that was day one. Man, it really do get a lot of seasons in one day. This morning there was frost all over the deck, and then now it's sunny and we're headed to hot springs.
So this is charqui. It's pretty much like jerky, but here, yeah.
It smells good.
The fire's in the center, the meat's in the roof. This is the way how Mapuche and people of the mountain live here.
People of the mountain.
Yeah.
I can dig it.
There is
the spot.
Oh, Jesus, it's fucking cold.
I thought this was hot.
Chupa la que
fue,
disco in South America.
These goes on the trees.
Arcaris.
This used to be the main road to go to Lonquimay and then Argentina. It's closed in winter by the snow, so it's gonna be very good for us. Tight trees and steep terrain. Let's see what the mountain have for us today. Natural sunscreen, that's it.
I'm good for the day.
I like a warrior.
Arr.
What you have here is a pair of jackasses. And they like to taunt each other on.
Even if they know it wasn't going to be successful, they would still do it just in spite of the other guy.
Right there, I'm gonna go turn it down.
You need to go to the hospital?
No, he's just done. You won't go there, right? The ACL and PCL kind of cross,
yeah,
and then the LCLs go out on the sides. I'm guessing you probably did an LCL.
Yeah, it hurts on my calf now, too.
I mean, anytime you go on a snowmobile trip, it doesn't matter if you're in South America, Colorado, or Wyoming, things aren't gonna go perfectly well. And you know, we've had broken ski, we've gotten lost, we ran out of snow one afternoon, we dropped so far down the road we ended up riding on dirt. I tore my knee, and our filmer Brian, he bruised a few ribs, so that's just part of the trip.
When you come down here, whatever your plan was, it's gonna change. You know, nothing ever goes according precisely to plan, but really it's about the adventure. You know, you just don't get this flavor in North America. The trees, this type of scenery, you know, the lava.
For me, it's like, we're just here to kind of explore things, and we're not here to push the limits. Like, we do that at home with our own equipment. Just being able to be here and to explore on the nice weather days, that's what I wanted. I wanted that more than good snow, just because I want to see what's here and where you can go and how far you can go.
The pinks and purples and reds that I see at night here up on the mountain. It's just euphoric.
You cannot go alone, so you have to go with good friends or good buddies who ride. So I think about the community, everything that grows around the sled is so good.
I think, you know, I've got a really awesome group of friends that we're down here with, and that right there is for sure going to be the greatest memories of all. And, you know, this is a trip that you'll remember for the rest of your life. I could probably come back here 10 years from now and still remember the exact routes we're riding right now.
Vaya folclórico, oye, disculpa la tardanza y los dolores de cabeza, ¿sabe? Agradezco tu paciencia y esta gran oportunidad. Dile,
ya tú ves.